friends. Welcome back to my channel and welcome if you're new here. My name is Jen. I'm a certified weight loss and nutrition coach and I'm on the WW or the Weight Watchers Blue Plan. Happy Friday. When you're watching this video, I'm living my best life in San Diego, California, visiting my best friend. I actually flew out on Wednesday and I won't be back until late in the day on Sunday. So I went ahead and pre-filmed this week's weigh-in. It is Wednesday that I'm filming. It is Wednesday that I weighed in. So it's really only been about a half of a week since my last weigh-in, but I wanted to weigh in prior to my trip just to kind of see how it all goes being on vacation. So if you're excited for today's video, give it a big huge thumbs up. And if you're new or you haven't yet subscribed, I would love to have you. Hit the subscribe button and click the bell right next to it so you never miss a single video. I do upload 5 days a week and Friday's always weigh-in day. Make sure you check out the description box down below where I just released two WW-friendly, calorie-friendly recipe ebooks. Breakfast and lunch both contain 15 recipes with all WW point plans and calories. Definitely get your hands on those to have easy on-track recipes at your fingertips. I offer nutrition coaching where I configure your macros and calories. Really, really recommend this as well. And if you want to chat with me directly, I have one-on-one coaching as well. Links, discounts to all my favorite things, and of course my Facebook group are also down in that description box. Come on over, join us on that community. We'd love to have you. So let's jump into the WW workshop topic, how my week went, and of course my weigh-in. So first, let's talk a little bit about my week. I had a stressful week, but a good week. Our floors were finished up this last Friday, so Troy and I spent 12 hours on Saturday getting our house back together. We cleaned, we organized, I mean, we cleaned everything. We were washing doors and windows. My right arm was so sore for a couple days after Saturday. I had 12,000 steps just in my house. So it was a very busy, productive day. And we are finally feeling like our house is back to normal. And honestly, it's cleaner than ever. So we're relieved that the flooring is done and that overall life in general is pretty back to normal. I had a really busy first part of the week just getting ready for my trip. I wanted to make sure all my videos were filmed and ready to go. Speaking of videos, there will not be a grocery haul or meal prep this week just because I will be out of town, but we will pick back up on Wednesday with what I eat in a day. So I just wanted to give you guys a heads up, and I will be posting in my community tab as well that there won't be those two videos this week. I will not be vlogging or filming my trip to San Diego. I just really want to enjoy the time with my best friend and just sightsee and just have a good time without the pressure of having to film all of that. However, I will be uploading regularly on Instagram. So if you don't follow me there, definitely give me a follow so you can keep up with me on my trip to San Diego. So like I said, I flew out on Wednesday. So right now I'm probably on a beach somewhere living my best life, which is exactly what I needed after a super stressful floor remodel. Luckily, my food was really good. I wanted to see a little bit of a weight loss again before I headed out for my trip and to really just end September out with a bang because I have lost weight all previous 3 weeks in the month of September. So we'll get into my weigh-in here in just a second, but I wanted to talk with you guys first about this week's WW workshop topic. And this is a really good topic. I think this is something that plagues most people. And this is how to stop late night snacking. Most of the time when we eat late at night, it's because we're in front of the TV or we're bored. And it's not because we're truly hungry. It's definitely that we're more snacky. In order to prevent late night snacking, we need to set ourselves up for success. We need to create an action plan, so to speak. First, we need to pinpoint a situation that leads us to mindless snacking. Late night snacking, late night binging. I know for me that when I'm watching TV, that's when I tend to want to have a snack. Not that I'm hungry because I just ate dinner an hour before, but just the act of watching TV makes me feel like I need a snack. And most of the time it's a healthy snack, but there are times that I'm reaching for the chips or cookies instead. So we want to decide ahead of time what we'll do when that snack craving hits. That way we can avoid in the moment decisions and we can really be mindful of our decisions when it comes to late night snacking. For me, I try to make sure that I save enough calories or points in order to have a late night snack or a snack while I'm watching TV before bed. That way I'm still staying within my calorie deficit or within my points, and I'm still able to work a snack into my day. And I figure if I don't have that late night snack, no harm, no foul. At least I didn't overeat. It's generally not a lot of calories or points that I've saved up. So I figure I'm covering myself in both situations, whether I have the snack or not have the snack. And now create a mock scenario. Fill in the blank. When blank, all blank. So for me, this would be when I'm watching TV, I'll have a healthy snack that fits in my points or calories. So therefore, I'm setting myself up for late night snacking success. In the event that I want a snack, I'm not overindulging and I'm just working that into my day. If you come up with a realistic plan, you're eating with intention. You're not mindfully eating, you're intentionally planning for a snack, eating that snack and feeling satisfied. And make sure whatever plan you set up for yourself is doable. Don't allow yourself 500 or 600 calories at night so that you're starving all day. And then when it does come to that late night snack, you're definitely eating 500 or 600 calories, if not more. Make sure whatever plan you set up for yourself is doable for you and your lifestyle. And remember, our bodies can't tell time. It doesn't matter when we eat. The only negative effect it can have is if you eat before bed, it can cause restlessness when you sleep. Sometimes we have heartburn, we're overly full, it just doesn't digest and sit in our body well. So it can cause you to maybe not have the best night's sleep, but having a nighttime snack that works into your calories or your points or both is not going to cause you to gain weight. Again, our bodies can't tell time. It really doesn't matter when we eat our calories as long as we're not in a surplus. So I really like this topic. It applies to me. It's something that I definitely need to think about because, like I said, when I watch TV at night, I need a snack. Wait, I don't need a snack. I want a snack. So I need to make sure that my want for a snack is included in my day. So let me know down in the comments if you're a nighttime snacker, bored snacker, what do you find yourself doing in the evenings when it comes to snacking? So now let's jump in to my weigh-in. So like I said, it was only a partial week. Last time I weighed in was Friday. It was Wednesday now, and I weighed in first thing this morning. And I'm happy that I continued my downward streak for the month of September. When I weighed in today, I am down 0.2 pounds. So that means that the 4 weeks in September, I lost weight every single week. I will go ahead and put here my overall weight loss for the month of September. I couldn't be happier. My goal for my trip to San Diego is to come back at maintenance. I know that there may be a slight weight increase just because of the foods that I'm eating. And generally when I travel, I retain water. So I generally am up in weight when I get back, but it goes away within a day or two. So that's my goal for my trip, is to pretty much maintain my weight and not come back with a big weight gain that I have to try to take off in October. So I couldn't be happier with my overall results from September. And now I wanna hear from you guys. Let me know down in the comments how your week was. Did you gain? Did you lose? What do you think of this topic? And are you a late night snacker? No shame in your game. Like I said, the majority of us suffer from some type of late night hunger or snackiness. So definitely let me know down in the comments. I can't wait to hear from you guys. If you enjoyed this weigh-in, give this video a big thumbs up. And of course, if you're new or you haven't yet subscribed, hit that subscribe button and join our community. We would love to have you. Thank you guys again so much for watching. Check out the description box for the recipe ebooks, nutrition coaching, and don't forget to join us over on Facebook. We have lots of fun stuff coming out over the course of the last 90 days of 2021, which is crazy, and over the holiday season. Thank you guys again so, so much for watching, and I will see you guys in a special fall-inspired video on Sunday. You're not gonna wanna miss it. Thank you again for watching. Happy Friday, and I'll see you next time. Bye.